While the state has been reporting daily positive test numbers by county, a new initiative by University of Hawaii researchers aims to pinpoint COVID-19 hotspots, and they're relying on community participation to do it. Gina Mangieri is always investigating and has more.
UH researchers say Hawaii needs to better identify critical areas where more priority or better containment needs to be done. And they say the community themselves holds the answers.
Places like South Korea and Singapore have been tracking the spread of COVID-19 down to the neighborhood, street, even individual level. Now the University of Hawaii's National Disaster Preparedness Training Center is building a similar model here in Hawaii. This one drills down as far as the closest intersection to your residence.
It involves basically identifying people that may have been exposed to the coronavirus and then tracking their movements and who they may have come in contact with. We look at this as information can help us provide some type of early warning.
More than 2,000 people have already filled out the online questionnaire in just days since the weekend launch.
We believe the community knows a lot. The community, so that we're trying to reach out to the community to get additional information, which is easy, it's fast, it's anonymous, and hopefully we can use this information to identify hotspots and locations where the disease may be in our community and then where it may have spread.
It's all voluntary and online.
We're asking people if they have a confirmed case of the coronavirus. Has someone in their household tested positive? Do you have any of the symptoms of the coronavirus? Have you traveled from places, high-risk places with lots of confirmed cases?
I asked more about the assurances of protecting anonymity of the participants.
We would never give, you know, specific addresses or locations. We have protocol in place to protect the anonymity and the confidentiality of sensitive information.
Part of that protocol includes oversight of the university's institutional review board.
We are in contact with others throughout the nation who are involved in this type of research. Traditionally, we would do this based on confirmed medical tests, but because of the limitation of testing capabilities and also how late we're getting started in this, and also how quickly the disease is spreading, we need additional data and information.
How will you begin sharing the data or visualizing it for the community?
Well, part of it is that we have to get enough people to participate in the questionnaire and the survey. We're definitely going to map this and try to identify hotspots and locations.
The researchers say even if you are well, go ahead and take the survey.
We are tracking the time that people submit their responses so we can look at old data versus new data. And it's okay if people submit if conditions change.
We've put up a link on our website where you can find the survey, and we'll continue to follow up as they publish maps and updates about what hotspots they're finding. Gina Mangieri, KHON2 News, always investigating.